Juliette Kayyem, CNN national security analyst and a former assistant secretary at the Department of Homeland Security. Juliette, good to see you. It was an incredible reading of all the charges Dzhokhar Tsarnaev faces, 30 counts, including using a weapon of mass destruction. Is there anything in this indictment that surprises you?
There are a few surprises, but I think most of the surprise is actually the tone, and that is it is Dzhokhar. You read this indictment, and there's nothing about the older brother. There's nothing about, oh, he's the hapless younger brother. He did a lot of things to make this attack work, and it outlines what that chronology is. So there's part of what this indictment is a public statement with enough about Dzhokhar being, you know, just the younger kid. He was seriously involved with downloading the information, purchasing ammunition, and essentially planning the attack. So this is just a full court press by the United States to say, you know, he is as guilty as his dead older brother.
Interesting. And what's the next step legally? He's arraigned next month?
Yes, he's arraigned next month, and I have been predicting at some stage we will, after the arraignment, we will get a request by the defense attorneys for a change of venue. That often happens in these high-profile cases. We saw it with Oklahoma City. The defense attorneys will argue, if this goes to court, that there's not a single person in Boston who can serve on a jury who wasn't directly impacted, in particular because of the lockdown. We were all impacted. And that will more likely than not be granted. And so there'll probably be another jurisdiction, even though the case can still be brought by the U.S. Attorney's Office in Boston. They just sort of move venue. But there's still a question of whether this will go to trial, right? Well maybe he will be willing to speak to authorities, and the death penalty will be taken off the table because it's on the table now, and he will go to a high-security prison for the rest of his life, but give us information about how did this actually occur? Because what's missing in the indictment is the question we've all been asking is how much help did his older brother get from abroad? How much foreign assistance was there? And there's nothing about that in the indictment.
And is that what you expect, just as somebody who has some experience in that they will plead out in order to take the death penalty off the table? We don't often see the death penalty actually take place in these cases.
Right. That's exactly right. I think that there are so many counts of which he could be executed. His defense attorney, she knows how to do these cases. And I think there's no question that a plea arrangement will be at least negotiated. And so that we can get information from him about the planning of this attack and any sort of foreign intelligence or foreign terrorist involvement. And that's how I think this will unfold over the next couple months. And this is the first step. But just clearly a statement that there should be no sympathy. There should be, you know, nothing about Dzhokhar being this younger brother. He was in charge. And that is what the indictment puts forward in a way we had never seen before.
All right, Juliette Kayyem, thank you so much.